Welcome back, YouTube, for another market analysis video for the London session. Today we're going to be going over S&P 500 and also gold. So we're going to be going over a 10 tick on S&P first for you guys. Take a look at some of the levels we'll be trading off of, and then we'll go over some of the levels we'll be trading off of on gold as well. So let's go ahead and take a look at what we're looking at. S&P 500, you can see we have some levels here. 1375 was an ideal level for us to look for today for price to be under or over as support or resistance. You can see we have something a little bit higher above where the price came to maybe about 1950-ish, right around there as the top level of resistance. And you can see how we moved down from there. We had a head fake up as we were ranging with that head fake up through that level and then came right back down as we had that open of the US session, and from there we started to use these levels as trading levels to play off of, and the market drifted its way down to as low as 83.75 and then came right back up. So you can see we have that strength move all the way back up into our resistance, where currently it peaked off at maybe right around these 18.28. All right, so we're going to see how price reacts here to this level. If we get back under 1375, it is going to look like a good opportunity to continue that short back down into the bottom of the range, somewhere right around there, like a double top, maybe like a two-try failure, head and shoulders pattern. So what we're looking for a failure there. But if we do get and press through this level and then we come back and retest as support, again, this is going to be a good opportunity, maybe after three rotations, to see some movement to the upside to continue the actual trend itself. All right, so we'll be looking at those two areas there. If we do get back down to the very bottom, right around the actual bottom of the range, we're going to be looking for an opportunity to bounce off here, show the support, and then take it right back up to the top. Now, if we break through that level, then again we'll look for a retest of the level as resistance, and then we'll look for an opportunity back down. So that's what we're going to be looking for on S&P, to show you guys exactly what it looks like here on our 5 tick as well, so you guys can see the levels play out. We're above 1375, and again we want to see maybe three rotations to hold this area as support and then continue it back up into 1950, and then again through that level we're going to have a continuation on up from there, right? So going to be some good opportunity if we get to these levels during the London session, we get to play off of them. Going to be some good opportunity. Might take something before it, given that we're around the area, but we're still going to have to wait for those rotations and see some movement from there. Let's take a look at gold here real quick, show you guys exactly what we're looking at. We did have a level of opportunity we were looking at earlier today, which is right around these 22s. It's kind of right around these 22 areas where we saw the drop off move. We were holding some support, as you guys can see, and then all of a sudden we moved right through it and then we came all the way down. All right, so a good move to the downside we had today. You can see the structure was clearly bearish, right? And we went sideways for a little bit, but sideways didn't really last too long. Had some good opportunities to short, some good opportunities to long, and then right through the level for excellent opportunities for a short side. So what are we looking at so far on gold? Well, gold has reached a support right now, and we're kind of bouncing between a couple levels. But this is going to be a good area to understand that we're going sideways for a little bit. I think we're probably going to find some support, but we might even press back down into the S1, but just kind of depends. But taking a look at it right now, we're bouncing between 97.5 as resistance and support coming in between these 94.2s, right? So what we're going to be looking for is the market to come down to the level and bounce. And if we don't get that bounce, we can even start to trade it a different way, right? You can gauge that higher low right here and start to short it back down to see if you can break the low, right? You're going to short it early back down to see if you can break the low. If you don't break that low, then of course you're going to exit the position and look for a long if you can't get a new low, right? Because the goal here to continue that downtrend is to make a new low. So if you don't make that new low, you're going to come right back up. Even if you do make the new low and you come right back up and you fail to push lower from there, going to see some rotations and then look for the long back up from there. All right, so definitely different opportunities we could be taking today, but on gold. But the best one right now is going to be looking to kind of short these 97 fives to continue that actual down move. But again, can't get that new low. Look for the upside, probably be attacking some of these resistance levels here, here, and also up here, right? So we are pretty low. We do have an S1 down below. Let's take a look at some of the technicals on here. You can see we're rounding out on the moving average. We're kind of right at the open right now. S1 is targeting somewhere down here at these 89 fives. So we do have a little bit of space. We got the VWAP overhead with the previous day close. So we've got some resistance overhead right now. The only thing kind of showing the support is that actual moving average holding that price up right now. So if we do break lower again, this could be your opportunity to try to get that new low or maybe even get a retest here and then try. But again, if you retest and you fail to make a new low, then get out of that short trade and look for that long opportunity. That's going to be your best opportunities to be looking for. Let's take a look at a five tick here with some technicals on it. Again, same thing that we were looking at earlier. These technicals are showing that the moving averages are slightly over, and we'll be heading back down to the bottom of the actual range. And potentially, we could be looking to make a new low here, right? So again, look for the retest to continue the downside, or retest to find the actual support, right? Looking like this. Sorry, lines are all over the place. Looking like this to find that bounce off this level, unable to break it, and then fade that back up. Or if you want to be on a conservative side, you can even wait for levels to break up here, then come back and retest the support, and you get that. Then you can try the upside of the VWAP and then higher to the previous day close point of control, right? So we'll be looking at those couple things right now. Well, tonight on the London session, it's going to be good levels to be trying to trade. If we are above these levels, we'll reassess the actual areas we're looking for, and we'll take some trades from there. But other than that, guys, that is our market analysis for the London session. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys are going to be in the room tonight, we'll see you guys in there. If not, you guys take care. Have a good night.